King Gabe Rosado, he's a fighter, he's a broadcaster. There's so much I want to talk to you about. Let's start with this. Ryan and Haney coming up. What's your prediction?
Oh, yeah, man. I think Haney's just, you know, more locked in, more focused. You know, I think Ryan got the skills and the talent, man. But I don't know if, if mentally he's stable to perform. You know what I mean? But I think, well, who knows? Maybe it's all a joke. Maybe it's all a gimmick.
Okay, what about Tank and Frank Martin?
Tank? Oh, no, man, Tank. You know, Tank's that dude. You know what I'm saying? So, Tank's that dude.
Okay, now, Bivola Bitterbite, who do you like?
Yeah. Frank Martin is a good fighter. You know what I'm saying? He's a good fighter, good skills. You know what I mean? I'm not counting him out, you know, but I just think Tank, you know, I've been a fan of Tank for a minute now, man, so I'm rocking with Tank.
Bivola Bitterbite.
Yeah, that's hard, man. I think Better Beef is a stronger, bigger puncher, killer. So, man, it's tough, man. But, you know, Bebop is just a good, good boxer. So, you know, it's the boxer or the puncher. Like, who do you go with? I'm leaning a little bit towards Better Beef. But, you know, Bebop could definitely put it off.
You've always been a big Canelo fan for many years. I've always interviewed you.
Yeah.
Him and Munguia, what do you think?
You know, I think Canelo is the more experienced fighter, the bigger puncher, but he got miles on him, and can that catch up to him? As far as Munguia, you know, he doesn't have, you know, the level of experience.
43 fights in, though.
Yeah, for sure. But you know, Canelo's another level. But Munguia, maybe his youth, his speed, his punch output, his activity, it might cause problems for Canelo. But, you know, we'll see. I lean more towards Canelo, you know, but I won't be surprised if Munguia pulls it off.
Jake Paul or Mike Tyson?
Oh, man. I'm going to just be a fan and watch it, man. You know, I'm a Mike Tyson fan. You know, Jake Paul is a good dude, doing good things for boxing. I called his last fight in Puerto Rico on the zone.
That was a movie.
Yeah, he put on a good performance. So, you know, I just want to be entertained. That's it, man. You know, I'm not really going for anybody.
Okay, let me ask you this. So who would you want to fight next? You still have a lot left in the tank.
Hey, man, you know, if a fight made sense. But, you know, I think a fight that would make sense would be Chavez.
Chavez Jr. I just saw him in the gym. He looks amazing. He's motivated. He's
hey,
a great
man. We've been talking about that fight for years.
You ever spar him?
Yeah, me and Chavez sparred years ago.
How was that?
It was cool. But hey, man, you know, who knows? We're both same age. You know, he's looking for a fight. Like I said, man, if it made sense, I think that'd be dope.
What does Fundora do with Errol Spence?
Fundora? I don't think that fight should happen.
Why?
Because Spence came off a loss. Why should he get a title shot coming off a loss?
Well, Fundora got a title shot off a loss, and he won 2 titles.
Oh, that's true. But you got to understand the circumstances. The circumstances were different. Fundora was already on the card, and Thurman got hurt.
Yeah.
So you need somebody to fill in, and it just so happens that Fundora's on the card, and he was the guy to fill in. So it's a different circumstance.
Nagab, you've been in movies, you've been in TV shows, you have a lot of experience. Hey, you got really skinny. My dentist cousin, super skinny. He lost all the weight. Used to be really big.
Yeah.
What do you make of Ryan Garcia's post? Is it trolling? Is it real?
Look, I don't even, if it's real or it's not, it's just not necessary. Because you gotta focus. This fight game is real. You gotta focus, bro. It ain't time to be trolling and doing none of that. You 2 weeks away from the fight. And you're saying some real outlandish things, bro. You're saying some real crazy things where it's like, even if it's a joke, it's like, where's your mind at? It ain't time to play. You know what I'm saying? Like, maybe he's trying to sell the fight. Who knows? But I just think, man, you're focusing on the wrong thing. You're trying to focus on selling this fight. You need to focus on trying to win this fight.
By the way, Richard Zinichin is fighting tonight. He's one of the best fighters in 140.
Yeah.
Who do you want to see Pitbull Cruz fight next? Teofimo, Haney, the Cuban kid.
Look.
Matias.
Matias is fighting in Puerto Rico.
Yeah, Subriel Matias.
Matias gets that dub.
Okay,
him and Pitbull.
Fight of the year.
Unification bout.
Fight of the year.
Yeah,
yep.
Puerto Rico, Mexico.
Yeah, I love it.
World title fight, man. That's,
okay, so that's how does Haney do with Teofimo?
How does Haney do with Teofimo? Haney?
If those two are fighting for the title, let's unify the other two.
I think Haney's more consistent. Teo's talented. He's a very gifted fighter. He's probably the most talented guy in the division. You know what I mean? He's probably the most skilled.
He's a lineal champ. Yep.
Guy in the division. But he's good one time and then he's off. I think his last fight, I think he lost to, what was it, Ortiz?
Well, he didn't lose. He won.
No, I know, but yeah. I'm saying, I don't think he won that fight.
Well, I didn't think Haney beat Loma, so.
Yeah, well.
All right, tell the fans where to follow you. King Gabe Rosado everywhere.
Gabe Rosado.
Are you broadcasting tonight?
Yeah, I just finished the opening bouts.
Amazing. Well, keep it up. You're multiple talented. And maybe Chavez Jr. Anything to tell Chavez Jr.?
What's up?
Anything to tell Chavez Jr.?
Yo, Chavez, man, stay working, man. Get back. Let's go.
All right, stay tuned. LA Stick Back reporting.